I mean, you can put what you want in a jambalaya, but this is kind of pretty standard. On the sausage front, it's traditional to either put in a chorizo for some spice, or a boudin, which is like the boiled sausage, but we've got this wonderful smoked sausage. Yeah.
And then into that goes the chicken. I've just seasoned them, put them into bite-sized pieces. That's it. Lovely.
Tasty. They do take themselves seriously, all the jazz men, don't they?
Yeah. What's that? It's great, because everybody has a jazz face, don't they? When they're off on one, they go...
Yeah. Oh, call Irving Mayfield. He's like this with his trumpet and swagger. And then when his mates are playing, it's like... Now, my rule next is to prepare the Holy Trinity. Celery, green peppers and onions. In this case, two green peppers, three sticks of celery, one onion, which should be chopped in the finest, most accurate way.
Just as the chicken and sausage are browned, then remove.
All of those meat juices and sausage juices and all of the herbs and flavours in that sausage has gone into the fat. And it's so lovely.
So into the olive oil, which now contains the wonderful flavours of the chicken and the smoked sausage, we put our holy trinity of green peppers, celery and onions, and we sweat this down. And pretty soon, this is going to be sweating like Louis Armstrong when he gets to a difficult bit.
While the veg sweats, put a slit in some tomatoes and soak in boiling water for a couple of minutes. Then it makes removing the skin a doddle.
There you go. Pop them into ice water if you want to cook the tomatoes, and you'll find it's remarkably easy to peel.
Good little tip, that, isn't it?
Now, get your spices ready. Paprika, cayenne pepper, oregano, thyme, and some garlic. Chuck in your spices and your roughly chopped tomatoes.
Chuck your cooked meat into there.
Give it a little stir-a-rooney.
And put in some rice. And this is just the regular quick cook, foolproof rice. Nothing fancy.
Now pour in some chicken stock.
And let that simmer for about 10 minutes until the rice is cooked. Mmm.
For a bit of crunch and even more flavour, add 8 chopped spring onions.
Stir them in. Cook them through a couple of minutes, just so they release all the flavours through that jambalaya, but they retain their texture.
Just lay on the top big shrimp or big king prawns. They've been peeled, got the tail on. Now, you can kind of sort these off first, put them in, stir them in, but just lay them on the top so they're cooking the steam en vapeur.
And then what happens, all of those lovely fishy flavours are released immediately into the jambalaya.
Oof. This is all the smells, the colour, the sensation of New Orleans. It's Bourbon Street in a pot.
It certainly is. Top on.
2 minutes. Yes. That is Mardi Gras in a pot. It's a mighty fine plate of food. Can't have it without...
Yes.
Louisiana hot sauce. Season at will.
Oh, yes.
If you can't get Louisiana hot sauce, Tabasco will do very nicely.
Mmm. Mmm. Mm. It's hot. Oh, hey. Mmm. Lovely sausage. All of the rice has just absorbed everything, hasn't it? All the chicken, all the sausage, the prawn. Well, that dances on your tongue like New Orleans dances in your heart, doesn't it? Oh. Fabulous.
And just like New Orleans, it leaves you wanting to come back for more. That is Chuck's steak. No.
No. Now, the chuck is from the shoulder of said beast. We're going to put that in the pan.
We're going to cover it with beef stock, which, we confess, has probably been made from a cube.
The stock gives the beef an extra bit of zip, then simmer the beef for 2.5 to 3 hours.
At this point, you should also soak your corn husks for an hour.
We're going to take the beef out, like so.
About 300 mils of stock into a pan.
And while Dave's doing that, I'm going to shred, but it needs to be nice and fine, this lovely piece of meat.
It's shredded, chopped, and actually it's ultimately going to become like a paste, isn't it?
Yeah.
Now, these are chipotle chilies, and these are two of the chipotle chilies that have been simmered, soaked, and left to cool in that beef broth. Put them in there with the beef stock, which, by the way, is now nice and smoky and pretty fiery hot. And we've got that lovely jug of chipotle chili paste. Now, the chipotles and the beef and what I'm doing now are all part of the hot beef core of the tamale. Take an onion and three cloves of garlic, finely chop and fry. Now it's time to turn the volume up to 11, isn't it?
Yeah.
2 teaspoons of black pepper, 2 teaspoons of salt, 2 teaspoons of sugar, 2 teaspoons of paprika, 2 teaspoons of cayenne pepper, and lastly, 1 teaspoon of ground cumin.
Get that.
La la!
Yeah. And all of a sudden, with 3 stirs of the spoon, we've got, like, the fire of Louisiana there.
Put the shredded beef into the onion and spice mix.
Add the liquidised chilies to the beef and around 200 millilitres of the beef stock. Give it a stir and let it bubble away for 5 minutes. Then leave it to go cold.
That is the core of the tamale. When you bite into something, this is the centre that sets your mouth, your senses alive. And we've actually made this, I think, a little bit hotter than Bernie's.
There is a smell in New Orleans, a smell of music and food. Mm. I know that might sound a bit mad, but there is.
So we're getting there. We have 2 out of the 3 elements. The salt corn husk, the hot beef centre. We need to make the dough.
Next comes some lard and 2 teaspoons of salt, and then whip it up.
Cool.
Look at that. You want the dough light and fluffy, so we're using self-raising flour for a bit of oomph. I'm going to put 2 teaspoons of baking powder into that to give it even more oomph.
A oomph.
Now, going back to Mexico, it's made with cornmeal. Pour the cornmeal into the flour and baking powder mix, then rub in the lard. I was born with my hands in lard, 'cause my life is awfully hard.
Nice work, though, Kingy. That's done, man.
Then heat up the remaining beef stock and mix that into the dough.
That is lovely. Nice. That is. Now, don't worry about this being a bit sloppy, because it is a paste we're looking for that we need to spread. We're not looking for, like, bread dough. Take the husk and lay it shiny side up, pointy end towards you. Take a spoonful of the dough and smear, like that. This is like the core of the nuclear reactor, the hot beef. Now, all this juice is going to cook into the corn. Now, with the skill of a Mexican grandmother, Kingy will show you how to wrap and roll.
What you do, just keep tucking, like that. 2.
1 tamale.
1 tamale.
And once you've rolled your tamales, you need to steam them.
Now, you take them and just pack them loosely, because remember, they are going to expand. That corn isn't properly cooked. Just in the top like that. The open ends, obviously, up there, so they don't absorb the liquid.
Just cut the ends off, yeah. It's like Mexican yenga, this. It's great.
Put the foil over the top. They will freeze, they will keep, so you can do a batch and have tamales every night of the week for the rest of the year, if you do enough.
Simmer for 1.5 hours, and the tamales will be cooked to perfection.
Oh, smell that.
Oh, nice.
Hot tamales. Hotter than Penelope Cruz when she's in the mood.
Ooh, look at these.
Wow! Hey,
they are kind of hot, like. That's spicy. Louisiana hot sauce.
Louisiana hot tamales. Party in your mouth.
All right, these are great.